None of Caesar's many powerful enemies really came close to the kind of power that Caesar himself had achieved by the time of his death. None except Lucius Cornelius Sulla, a man with a huge, though not necessarily positive, impact on Caesar's early life. Sulla seized total control over the Roman state after a civil war with Gaius Marius and Cornelius Cinna, who were Caesar's maternal uncle and father-in-law, respectively. What followed was a period of utter terror against Marius and Cinna's supporters. Caesar, with his family connections, was an obvious target. Luckily, he also had relatives among Sulla's supporters, who successfully intervened on his behalf. Sulla stripped Caesar of his fortune and his position, but not of his life. Caesar fled Rome and did not dare return until the death of his persecutor. It is said that the events surrounding Sulla's dictatorship made a deep impression on Caesar as a human being, and was the main cause for his later insistence on clemency toward his Roman enemies. It seems ironic that Sulla, who was notorious for his cruelty and his bloodthirst, died relatively peacefully, while Caesar was stabbed to death by his own friends in the most heartbreaking way imaginable.